what's going on? It's this old outboard on outboard painting. First of all, you're going to need an old, beat up, crappy looking outboard. And let me say right off the bat, this is not a restoration. It's just a, you know, quick way to clean up the outboard and make it pretty. And people ask me all the time, where do I get the paint that I'm using? And I just kind of stumbled onto it one day. I was at O'Reilly's Auto Parts. Here's the paint here, the VHT. I think this is actually a drivetrain paint. It's chemical resistant, high heat. And I thought it was, you know, pretty close match. And so I gave it a shot one day. Anyway, excuse me. First and foremost is, of course, this thing's got to be clean as possible. And I'll use like the Purple Power or the Mean Green, one of those chemical cleaners, degreasers, because on these older outboards, the paint is pretty much, you know, shot anyway. And the degreasers actually strip off the dead paint. Works really well. Hit it with a pressure washer, blast all that dead paint off. And if it's really beat up, you've got to sand it. And I use a sander, hand sander, and I'll even use a wire brush on the end of a drill, you know, smooth it out a little bit. And excuse me again, for primer, this is a primer surfacer, which you can pick it up right there at the auto parts stores or anywhere that sells paint, Home Depot, Lowe's, that type of thing. And what that does is it hides all the scratches and imperfections. And I like to put it on really thick. And, you know, not one giant heavy coat, but coat after coat after coat, until it actually starts to hide stuff. Now, you're not going to hide everything, of course, but it actually works pretty well. Then, once I get it, you know, pretty much where I like it, I like to shoot the paint on there when it's still, the primer is still sticky. And it seems to, you know, bond pretty good. And if you're lucky enough to take the power head off and stuff like that, it's a little easier, you know, with pieces and parts. But you can paint the whole thing all together. If you've ever taken a power head off, you'll notice that sometimes they come from the factory, put together, and then painted, because underneath the power head, there is no paint. You'll see on the older motors, see a nice primer coat on the power head, but underneath, there's no paint where it just doesn't get hit going through the assembly line. Now, I may have some double pictures here, but this is a couple of three outboards, I think. I just grabbed some pictures to put this together. Once again, primer surfacer covers up the imperfections and the high heat chemical resistant paint from the auto parts store. And I think pretty much all those auto parts stores sell this stuff. But I was getting it at O'Reilly's, which they had just opened one up fairly close to my house. So it was easy just to run in there. Here is everything is put together on this motor. Hitting it with the primer, that you can see the power head has already been primed and painted. And yes, there is some double shots here with the pictures. I guess I went a little crazy trying to scarf up all the pictures I could find. Anyway, you can see it's a light coat there, and you just want to shoot it on there, you know, as light, not real light, but you don't want to, you know, kill the damn thing right off the bat. Then once you get it all painted up and everything, you start, you know, give it a couple of days or a day or so, depending on where you live, how fast it's going to dry, what's the temperature outside, humidity, blah, blah, blah. So, anyway, you can start putting it back together once it's dry. I've put them back together, you know, they're still a little sticky, got some fingerprints on them, but, you know, always in a hurry. Here's a ear case, took it off and painted it, and I do have more pictures, it's just tough to scarf these things up at the last minute, but that's pretty much it. I mean, people ask me all the time. Now here you'll see the pit marks on this. Like I said, it's not a restoration. Now you can get these pit marks out and use that cream body filler, fill them in. It's like a red colored cream. It comes in a tube. Fill all those imperfections in if you want to go nuts. It's just like doing the car, you know, you gotta, I mean, I wouldn't go crazy and use Bondo, but you could, but you can fill those imperfections in with that cream. Now here you'll see that's the original paint of the Powerhead, and then the body on this thing is the paint I put on, so it's a pretty close match. This one here is full paint, both the same color, painted them from the auto parts store, and same thing here, same color, Powerhead, body, all the same color. This one here, I actually hit it with some extra primer, didn't like the way it was looking, you know, did some wet sanding in between coats, and smoothed it out, shot it again, a little extra primer, and hit it again with the paint, and came out much better, you know. And it's fairly cheap, you know. You could, which would probably be better if you really want to get serious and go to some of these hardcore paint stores like Sherwin-Williams and order, you know, some really good paint, not just this can stuff. And of course you're going to have a sprayer and that type of thing, but just for a quick cleanup, and it lasts pretty good too, because I had sold all these motors, I had sold, so I never knew really what happened with the paint down the road. But one guy had brought a motor back to me probably a year or so later, called me up and said, hey, I'm having trouble, I can't get this thing started. I said, bring it back, and man, I saw it and got a big smile on my face how well the paint actually held up. And if you want to go really crazy, you know, you can always clear coat it too after you paint it. Another shot of that motor with the Powerhead, the original blue, compared to the metallic blue engine paint. It's not the same, but once it's all done, it looks great. Another thing too, which, I mean, you're on your own with this stuff here, but I had bought a can of the Evinrude touch-up paint, you know, to match, because it's almost impossible to paint that damn, or match that damn white Evinrude Johnson color. Anyway, here's a motor I did in white. Probably using the same type of paint. To be honest with you, I can't remember which paint this was, but I knew better than to put anything on there that as soon as you spill a little gas on it, was going to eat it off. And that's where I was getting at with the touch-up paint, the OMC touch-up, Evinrude touch-up paint. I bought a can of that, and it was expensive. I think I paid like 12, 13 bucks for a freaking can. And man, as soon as it, you know, I even did a test on it, man. I took a little gas and man, it just wiped right off. So, you know, if you use that stuff, you're on your own with that. It's got to be a chemical resistant, you know, enamel or, you know, I'm not really a big paint guy, but I mean, I know it has to be chemical resistant. So anyway, that kind of boils it down right there of what paint that I've used on these things, and it actually turned out and worked pretty well. Thanks for watching. And stay thirsty, my friend.